Flav City fam, what is up? It is Bobby coming at you at the grocery store for a budget video. I'm super stoked about this one because I want to show you the top five or so budget-friendly tips for eating healthy. I'm talking about nutrient-dense foods that pound for pound and ounce for ounce, you will get the most nutrition out, but also save you the most money. Because if you eat healthy, it doesn't have to be expensive. I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that in the grocery store. Before we get in there and do our thing, like, subscribe, share, spread that Flav City love. But I also want you to check out thrivemarket.com using my promo link down below. Thrive has not just been a supporter of my channel for 6 years, but they have great healthy budget options. The cool thing is, per order, you save about $32 compared to going to a grocery store, and the box comes to your door. You never have to go outside. They have this cool thing out there for all the budget-friendly people. It's a price scanner on their app. You can scan any barcode at any grocery store. It'll tell you if it's cheaper on Thrive Market. And right now, most importantly, the Flav City fans are getting the hookup. When you click my link in the description box, you get 25% off your first order, a free gift up to $31. One of those options is a bottle of Primal Kitchen avocado oil and ranch, and it's 30 days risk-free. So if you don't love it, you could always cancel, get your membership fee back, but at least you tried it. So check them out using my link down below. Okay, less talking, more shopping. Let's go find some budget finds. There is an amazing way to get serious discounts on all this beef, chicken, and pork. All you have to do is come to the grocery store and look for this. This was just put on the meat literally a minute ago. This is the markdown because today's 5/19, tomorrow is the use-by date. My friends, this is not an expiration date. It's your use or freeze-by. And you actually have up to 2 days after that to use it or freeze it. And the biggest score, in my opinion here, is the grass-fed beef. You guys know I love grass-fed beef, and nutritionally speaking, it's even more superior. I've never seen it for $1.09 off because this is coming up on the use-by date. Don't be scared of use-by dates. They're not expiration dates. When this video is done, watch our video called Stop Throwing Away Expired Food. Those are dates that they just have to get it out of here by. But like I said, you have up until 2 days after to use it or freeze it, which means you get amazing savings. So what I would do is game plan it, right? Come to the grocery store or a couple grocery stores ahead of time, see the use by dates, and then today is 5/19. So I walked up to one of those guys over there, right? And I said, hey, is it time to mark this down? And he actually did it for us. He came over here, broke out his sticker thing, and put the new price on there. That's a great way to game plan it, right? Go in like a coach, like a sergeant, and know when this meat is gonna be on a serious savings. And you can get great meat that has protein, iron, minerals, and even better with the grass-fed beef for serious savings. It's amazing how many people waste their money, in my opinion, on multivitamins and vitamins that don't work. And the thing is, these are expensive. And you don't want to have to buy five or six different ones. If you have to get one vitamin, I would say get a multivitamin. The problem is, many multivitamins at the grocery store are not worth the money. For example, something like this. This is a very popular multivitamin for all different ages, men and women. The thing is, this is very important. When you're looking at a multivitamin, you want the ingredients and you want the types of vitamins to be vast and diverse. This is not that impressive to me, but always look at the other ingredients when it comes to vitamins and supplements. This is where it gets scary for this one. See something there called BHT? That's a very controversial food preservative that's banned in other countries. There's blue number 2, there's red number 40, and yellow number 6. They're using food coloring to make these pills look a different color. And there's something called titanium dioxide, which is really bad for you. In addition to those horrific ingredients, it's not that good of a multivitamin. You're just wasting your money. Luckily, I've done a whole video about the best quality men's, women's, and kids' multivitamins. And I went back to there and I looked at the ones that this is the cheapest, and it's a Garden of Life gummy for men's and women. That's the best one. And yeah, it's still more expensive than any of these, including this one. It's on Amazon, but it's also on Thrive Market for the same exact price. But when you use my link down below, you get 25% off your first order on Thrive Market. So it turns out to be cheaper. Plus you get the 30 days risk-free and that free gift. Thrive Market is the best. I also put all my Thrive Market favorites in the description box. Check them out. Just stop buying these cruddy supermarket multivitamins. They're not even worth the money. How do we eat seafood on a budget? Well, you want to look for the most nutrient-dense fatty fish possible. So something like a shrimp, I wouldn't get, right? It's not as nutrient dense, and I love it, but it's not gonna give me the most bang for my buck. It's gonna be right here in this frozen case. Now I have choices. I have tilapia, which I wouldn't recommend, flounder and cod, decent options, salmon, really good options, and stuff like wild-caught swordfish and ahi, maybe not as nutrient dense as I'd like, and bigger fishes like these tend to have more mercury. I would live right here. This is a great place to go for budget-friendly, nutrient-dense fish. Salmon, both farm-raised and wild-caught right there. The cool thing about salmon, it's got omega-3s. It's got antioxidant. It has vitamin B, vitamin D. Ideally, you want to get wild-caught, and this is a great deal. This is the Walmart brand. My friends, it's $9.12 for a two-pound container of wild-caught salmon. That's $4.61 a pound, whereas the farm-raised Chilean Atlantic salmon here is $7.24 a pound. Now, the only thing is, this pink salmon here, it's a product of China, which is not ideal, but when you're on a budget, sometimes you have to sacrifice things here and there. I would still go for that because that's $4.61 a pound. If you come over here, Brad, let the traffic go through, you'll see the USA wild sockeye salmon is way more expensive at $11.93. And then the farm-raised salmon here for the fresh is just a little more at $7.84 versus $7.24. So I would go for salmon, ideally for wild-caught if you can, but good quality farm-raised is good too because it's gonna pack the most punch, nutritionally speaking, for your dollars. If you're a Costco shopper, they have a great deal, $9.99 for a wild-caught salmon, but leave comments down below. If you know a great price for wild-caught or good quality farm-raised salmon, it's all about sourcing the best price and getting the best salmon in your belly. I almost forgot. If you want to get your berry fix on and you don't want to buy the organic berries because they're so darn expensive, come to the frozen section. They usually have organic berries and they cost way less. I think this is the only option, this Walmart. It's the organic triple berry blend. And the cool thing is it's 10 ounces for $2.36. That's way cheaper than buying the fresh ones. And I don't mind the texture of frozen berries once they're thawed out. They're a little mushy, but you put them in smoothies or top them on top of yogurt or something like that. This might even be a better deal. This is wild blueberries. Because it's a wild and crazy guy, you actually don't have to buy organic for wild because they're not dirty at all. And wild blueberries have way more antioxidants than regular cultivated ones. This is not the best price, even though it's decent. Go to a BJ's or a Costco. I'm not sure if Sam's has it. Does anyone know? Leave a comment down below. You can get a huge bag of these for a ridiculous price, and you're seriously saving money compared to buying the fresh ones that, are, to be honest, are cultivated in fat. These are wild blueberries, and they taste great. Rice is such a common staple, not only around the world, but especially when you're on a budget. Why? Because rice is super cheap. But there is a way to upgrade your rice with minimal expense. A lot of people will just gravitate towards this, white rice. This is enriched rice, but any kind of white rice people tend to get. The thing is, this stuff really is not only cheap, it's cheap in a nutritional sense. I talk about this a lot. This kind of food is nutritionally dead because this used to be something like a brown rice, which I'll talk about in a second, but it has all the good stuff stripped away. The hull, the bran, the fiber, all the good stuff that makes nutritionally speaking it better is gone. So at this point, it's just a simple carbohydrate that has no nutrition at all that they enrich it, and it spikes your blood sugars like crazy. But the crazy thing is, look at this. This, my friends, is 3.9 cents an ounce. If you just trade up to brown rice, which nutritionally speaking is so much better, it's only 4.3 cents an ounce. That's a difference of 0.4 of a penny for something that has way more fiber because it's not stripped out. The hull, the bran, the fiber is still in here. So it's such an easy swap. Get rid of white rice, get brown rice. I think it tastes better. It's slightly more chewy. Ideally, the best thing would be like a wild rice, which they don't even have here at Walmart, but that's way more expensive. Forget about it. Just get brown rice. It's an easy swap. And the same is true for spaghetti. It might be slightly, I'm talking slightly cheaper to get enriched wheat or white wheat pasta, but nutritionally speaking, it's much more expensive because your body's not deriving anything. Look at this. This is made with durum wheat, not the whole wheat, but see all the stuff there in the niacin, the thiamine, that's enriched wheat pasta. There is no nutrition. They stripped all the good stuff out, so they have to enrich it. 1 pound box for 78 cents. Somewhere here on the wall, they have an organic, or not an organic, a whole wheat version of it. Bum, 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 bum. There it is. So, a little more expensive. It's a dollar, right? But look at this. This is the whole wheat spaghetti, the same version, but it doesn't have any of those nasty, enriched, inferior vitamins here because it's the whole wheat. It's the same concept as the rice. You want the whole grain because it has the bran and the fiber and more nutrients, not putting those cruddy nutrients in there. $1, a little more expensive, right? Ideally, I would even trade up to something like a lentil pasta or some kind of legume pasta, but it's way more expensive because that doesn't have gluten and that has more fiber and more protein too. If you go on Thrive Market, they have an excellent selection of organic pasta and legume pasta made out of beans. Use my link down below because you get the extra 25% off your first order and the free gift, and it's 30 days risk-free. It's really, really good nutrient-dense pasta that has awesome ingredients for a great price. Ah, this is super interesting. Let me show you in a second. When it comes to bread, look for, once again, the most nutrient-dense whole grain bread loaded with seeds and nuts and all that good stuff. But look at this. This is Pepperidge Farm. Fancy-looking bread because it's wrapped in paper. I've actually never seen that. But this is 24 and a half cents an ounce. And it says 100% whole wheat. And yes, it is whole wheat, but it has horrible soybean oil in there and not many other ingredients that add to the whole grains and nuts and seeds. If you're at Walmart, this is actually your best option here. And look at this, 18 and a half cents compared to 24 and a half cents for the non-nutritious bread. This is organic, Dave's Killer, with 21 whole grains and seeds. If you compare the ingredient profile to the one I just showed you, look at all these amazing nutrient dense, good for you nuts and seeds. My only knock on this one, has a little too much sugar per slice, but still you're way better off with something like this compared to even whole grain like that. Doesn't have a good ingredient profile. That certainly doesn't. The best deal, most warehouses will have the big loaf of Dave's Killer. Costco will have the frozen Ezekiel bread, just sprouted grain bread. Just look for something like that that has tons of nuts and seeds and whole grains, not these filler breads that actually are more expensive. Please do not buy any cereal at the grocery store. None are healthy. They're actually expensive and a waste of money. And I think it's criminal, literally criminal, that they can sell churros for breakfast and put cartoons on the cover of the box here. And who thought it was okay to have oatmeal cream pies for breakfast? Something is wrong when you're having oatmeal cream pies for breakfast. These are all made with sugar, grains, horrible ingredients. Even if you go down there to the ones that are heart healthy with whole grains, keep in mind, these are grains that have been processed and extruded. They're not good for you. They only spike your blood sugar and they have no nutrition. You're way better off just going to get some fresh eggs, even the cheap eggs for $1.18 a dozen, and making your own breakfast with eggs. The eggs have lutein, which is good for your skin, saturated fat, a healthy version, protein. That's the kind of stuff you need. No one needs Tony the Tiger in their life. They're not great. All right, family, that is it. Those are five super solid budget-friendly tips for eating healthy. If you want to see more budget-friendly videos, let us know. Leave a comment down below. We were maybe thinking of combining hauls with recipes, which could be super fun, but you let us know because we always make the videos you guys want to see, and budget seems to be very popular. Right, Brad?
It does.
So leave a comment down below. Like, subscribe, share, spread that Flav City love. It's the only way the channel keeps growing, and it's also the only way we help y'all put the best quality stuff in your body. But for Bradley, myself, and the whole gang, we leave you like we always do. Hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love and peace. Later.